Hey again, I'm Aliash, and with the latest One Home update, we have added a lot of new functionalities to have a better insight into your system. One of those is graphs. This makes it easy to overview the state of your home over a period of time with a simple glance. Let's look at how it works. Yet again, we are back at our device's view of the One Home dashboard. At the first glance, it doesn't seem any different. But if we go into a specific device, we can now see that we have two tabs. We have Configure and we have History. If we click on History, we get a history for this device. Here, in case of a humidity sensor, we can see that we have a history that is set by default to 24 hours, but you can also change this to a different time range. This way, you can quickly overview the state of the device and see if there are any weird trends going on that you might have to take care of. For example, maybe if the humidity is high, you have to adjust your ventilation automation to mitigate this issue. But this is not the only way where you can see graphs. While useful for a specific device, we want to have also a better overview of your whole project. If we go under graph section on the left side, you can now see a whole section dedicated only to graphs. We have on the left side all the rooms with the number of how many automatically generated graphs are already created for this specific room. Usually you want to know for each room what's the temperature, what's the humidity, what's the brightness, are there any contact sensor, occupancy and similar. And this is why we automatically populate this section with those graphs. There are also other rooms that you can view. For example, dining room. Here we again see the temperature, the humidity. We can also see that if there are multiple sensors of the same type in the room, we simply show all of them on the same graph. But this is not the only thing you can do. You can also create custom graphs. For that, we go under Add. And in the case of a dining room, we also have a CO2 measurement available. We didn't add it as a One Home device, so we will use it on a graph as a group address directly. Let's name the graph CO2. Let's click Add. And here we have an option to create our metric. We can select from a device or group address. If we were to select device, then we would be able to select a different attribute of a device. For example, on a thermostat, we could use set point, we can use current temperature, we can use mode, we can use if it's on or off, or simply show all of this on the same graph. But for now, let's use the group address and let's search for the dining room CO2 value. And it's here, dining 2 CO2. It automatically pre-selects the DPT if it's available in the ATS. And let's click create. Now we have the graph of the CO2 value. What's left to do is to click create, and we have the custom graph here. But of course, it's not just about CO2, temperature and humidity. One of the great things you can show on a graph is energy. Let's create a custom view for energy. Let's click on create. Your energy view has appeared under this custom section. And now we can create a graph of energy for electric car charging. Let's click Add Graph, let's click Car Charging, and let's add metrics. So again, we will do this with a group address here. I already know the group address, so I will just type it in. This is for the current power consumption, and click Create. And we see it here. And we will add for a total consumption, which again, group address. And we will do add. And on this graph, we can now see how the energy consumption was happening at every specific moment, and also how the total energy consumption was being accumulated through time. If I click create, now I can also see this chart here in the energy section. And what we can also do is change the time range. We have different options from 5 minutes all the way to 7 days, or you can also create a custom range. If I select, for example, a custom range, I can select it from, let's say here, until today, and let's click select. And I can see how the car charging was done. We can clearly see here was time for some vacations, and here we came back home and the car charging started to happen again. I love graphs. They give you so much insight at a simple glance, and I'm sure you love them too. Make sure to check them out and see you in the next one.